gonna attempt this right now.
I had originally forgotten to film an intro, but ladies and gentlemen, my name is Alex Valoria, and I'm so glad to be back.
Now notice in the title, it says, the hardest riff I've ever heard. Not the hardest riff that exists, because I'm sure there are harder ones out there, I just don't know they exist, because I haven't heard it yet. So that's where I need your help.
Can you help me, mister?
If by the end of this video you think you have a harder run and you want to challenge me, leave it in the comments below. I want to take on your challenge. Okay, so if you've watched me before, then you probably know that I enjoy doing riffs or vocal runs, whatever you want to call them. I've even made a series about, you know, how fun they could be to learn on the spot against my buddy Leo.
And the way you
If this is your first video that you're watching of mine, welcome. What is a vocal run or riff? Now, I don't know anything about music, like theory or technicalities of it, but in my own definition, from an ordinary singer, it's just a quick succession of notes that you do with your voice. I would say anything over like three different notes in the succession would be considered a vocal run or riff. There are super easy riffs, like the three-note riff that just goes down in steps.
Way to go.
And then there are super hard ones. Where it sounds like a hurricane of notes. And that's what we're gonna be trying to learn today. Okay, so there's beginner level vocal runner, riffer. Then there's me. And then there's this guy, people like this guy. His name is Avion Falstar. I'm not even gonna say anymore. Let's just listen. Just marinate in that, okay? Just bathe in it for a second. Let your soul just bathe and marinate in that. Can we just take a moment to appreciate that for everything it is? Not only the physical agility required from your vocal cords to be able to do that, but think of the creativity. How do you sit down there and then just think when you're singing, I think I'm gonna... Hearing that is like the visual equivalent to somebody flashing 40 different colors in my face in the span of 3 seconds and then asking me to recite every single color I saw. And I was colorblind. But I'm gonna try to learn that. Now, again, I'm an intermediate, like I'm no stranger to vocal runs, but I'm also not that. If every riff before has come to me naturally, how am I gonna do it when this doesn't come to me naturally at all? I can't even hear it. It's like another language. The thing that I teach my students is if you wanna learn a riff, you need to be able to break it down, start slow. Now, the thing about vocal runs, no matter what level they are, is once you've practiced it enough, it becomes kind of muscle memory for your vocal cords. It's kind of like remembering a combo for a video game. You don't really think about it, you just do it from muscle memory. So I'm gonna be going back to the drawing board and taking my own advice today, and we'll see how it goes. Before we move on, I've linked Avion's video in the description below. Check it out for yourself, it's amazing. Avion, if you're watching this, huge fan, I think you're amazing. Please don't copyright claim me, okay? Camera angle is so like... So this is the actual snippet of that exact riff from the YouTube video. I'm gonna slow it down 20%, and this is how it sounds broken down. I don't even understand it still, even when it's slow, I can't, whatever. So what I'm noticing is it's mainly divided up into three sections, and the first one is kind of easy, relatively easy. But then the second one is when it gets kind of like a blur. And then the third one is also a blur, but it's mostly going down. So easy, I can do it. So what would a progress video be without me displaying the very start of that progress? A terrible one. So I'm gonna attempt this right now without ever having approached it from a learner standpoint. Easy, watch.
And so I practiced before bed. I practiced on a mountain. I practiced while hanging out with all my friends.
Okay, so if we're talking about time that I've just purely sat down, listened, and/or practiced the riff, I'm probably sitting at about 2.5 hours to be safe. And of course, it wasn't 2.5 hours straight. It was more like 30-minute segments spread across a few days. This isn't gonna be pretty. I guarantee.
Is that middle part, dude? I'd probably sing it a little bit better if my torso was upright, but this carpet is too comfortable right now. So if you remember previously how we divided it up into three segments, I believe for the most part I've got the first segment down. The third segment I've also, I think, got down. But the middle segment, it's still a blur to me. I still don't really comprehend every note that he's jumping to. Therefore, I can't replicate it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slow down the whole track by another 20% purely for that middle part. And hopefully with another 2 hours of practice, I can have it fully down.
And so I kept practicing on more mountains, in the car, and while hanging out with my family.
Breath when it's slow. So I'd say I'd master, finally, I've mastered the second part. And that one was scary for me because at first I didn't even understand it. And even when it was slowed down 25%, I still didn't understand it. But it kind of puts into perspective the progress that I've made so far. And now I understand all of it. So the next part is actually learning it up to speed. Maybe that'll take me another 30 minutes, hopefully. Now, actually, along the way, I challenged Leo to see if he could do the riff. So let's see how that went.
If you can nail this riff that I'm about to show you,
okay,
I will Venmo you $100.
$100?
Cash, right now.
Why?
Each day that goes by.
Why?
Because the trick is how hard it is. But
okay.
Each day that goes by,
okay,
you lose 20 bucks.
Okay. I mean, how hard could it be?
Yeah, I mean, it's so easy.
It's just, let's listen to it. It's easy. Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right. That's, you want to try it? I got the $100 all
knocked. Okay,
right,
ready?
It's ready.
Right.
I'm about to press send.
That $100 about to go out.
Yeah.
Dang it. That was like, I'd say that was like 96% there, right? Come on, cut me some slack.
Just one more day.
I think tomorrow's the day that I'm gonna get it. I can feel it in my bones.
And my vertebrae were right, mostly.
Okay, here we go. That was it.
That was.
I freaking did it. I had to transpose it into a little bit of a lower key because my vocal range isn't as high as his. I'd have to do most of the riff in falsetto if I did it in his key. The principle remains the same. I just did that riff in my own key.
And as for Leo's progress,
have you been practicing? Have you been doing your homework, mister?
A little bit.
I mean, my thing's not loading, but do you think you could just give it to us raw for a bit, real quick?
No.
For consolation, I'll take you out for food tomorrow.
Wow. So wow. Nice.
Everybody, that was Lee.
Can I have my facial hair?
Oh, yeah. What you guys like is, he looks like a pug to me.
I fucking hate when you say that.
So what was the point of this entire video? Well, just show off. No, I'm just kidding. Point of this entire video and the point of my entire channel is not only to educate you about how to learn how to sing,
and make it fun along the way. But it's to show you that I'm just a guy with vocal cords, just like you. And if I can learn how to do 30 blah 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 notes in a matter of 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 seconds, then nothing is stopping you from learning how to sing a song, because the method is the same. If I can learn 36 notes in the span of 3 or 4 seconds, then you can apply that method into learning how to sing a song beautifully. And there's nothing stopping you from doing that. You memorize and learn how to repeat the melody of a song over the span of 3 minutes, and most of which is repeated anyways over the, you know, 2 choruses and 2 verses and pre-choruses, etc. You're in business. That's how you learn how to sing. That's how I learned how to sing. And then eventually you get enough experience singing other people's songs, and then you write your own song. Now that I've conquered this riff, I am hereby proclaiming that I, Alex Valoria, can learn any riff. I know, it's completely true, right? So now this is where you come into the picture. Next week, I'm gonna be doing another one of these videos, and I want, give me your hardest riff. Throw me your hardest riff, the one that will send me to the ER. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this video. It's a wild ride. I've been taking a little bit of a break from my Patreon, but check it out down below. I'm starting up my vocal lessons again. If you wanna get personally trained by me, or if you want quick singing and guitar tutorials, I haven't uploaded in a bit, but thank you so much for being patient. I appreciate you guys from the bottom of my heart for sticking by my side through what was a really weird time in my life. And I'll see you next time.